Hello, I'm Mark Lomas here in Saint-Étienne, covering Euro 2016 for Sport 360. We've just witnessed a great game of football, Portugal 1, Iceland 1. Delighted to be joined by Icelandic journalist Johan. What a game for you, Johan.
Oh, absolutely. Our first game ever in a major tournament to get a 1-0 draw against a great team like Portugal. Absolutely overdue. It's a hard-fought game. They even took the lead, and to come back like that, absolutely over the moon.
What were your expectations before the tournament in terms of how far you thought Iceland might be able to get?
I would be absolutely delighted to get out of the group stage, to get to the last 16, and that was it. I would be delighted to get so far, and I wouldn't be too down even if we wouldn't get so far. So I was maybe cautiously optimistic, but after these results, we better get to the last 16.
I was going to say, you must be confident now, and there must even be a little bit of expectation that you could even get to the quarterfinals, maybe?
I'm not thinking that far. I was actually thinking if we lose today, we still have two winnable games left. But after this, I'm still thinking last 16. I have to be happy with that.
Do you think the Hungary game, does that result do you any favours? Is that a good result for Iceland? How do you see that going?
Everybody actually looked at that game and we were expecting Austria to win it. So everybody expected Austria to win and Portugal to win, and the Hungary versus Iceland game is going to be crucial for both teams. Kind of turns the group around now. But I don't think it really matters in the end. You still have to play these teams. So in the end, I don't think it matters really.
Who were the players who sort of made the difference today for Iceland? Who was it who you thought particularly impressed?
Our goalkeeper was massive. That save from Nani in the first half was out of this world. Adam Gunnarsson, our captain, the midfielder, he was almost playing like a third centre back. He was covering the whole field, and when needed, he went to the back to help our centre backs. And our centre backs, of course, were massive. And it's kind of funny that Kauri Almason used to play for Plymouth Argyle, used to play for Rotherham, and he had no problems with Ronaldo whatsoever. It's like he has done nothing in his life other than covering Ronaldo. It was amazing.
And just from a personal point of view, as well as a journalist, because we talked a little bit, you were sat next to me in the press box, I saw your incredibly enthusiastic reaction when I scored. You got a tattoo as well, right?
Yeah.
I like that. I saw your incredibly enthusiastic reaction when Iceland scored as well. You mentioned that usually when you go to cover games in Iceland, there's only maybe attendances of 1,000. Obviously, you're in an enormous stadium here. What was the experience like as a journalist for you covering the game here?
Tremendous, absolutely. Just to see the stadium. I saw the stadium yesterday. I was just looking at the team's training, and I was looking at the empty stadium, and just looking at the empty stadium was an experience for me. Excuse me. Like you said, I'm usually covering games with maybe 2,000 people attending. And even in the lower league games, I might be the only journalist. So it's something completely different, but I could get used to it. So.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much indeed for joining us. And I guess best of luck to Iceland on what should be an incredible journey.
Yeah, thank you. I've actually heard that everybody supports Iceland that isn't from the country we're playing. So.
Yeah, definitely lots of mutual support for Iceland. Do you think that Iceland can get further in Euro 2016? Let us know. Visit sport360.com or talk to us on social media as well, at sport360 or facebook.com/sport360.